Stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea. Just forgot on the shelf, the wind and the sails, going nowhere with no one but me. I was one in 100 bills, a burnout star in a galaxy. Just lost in the sky, wondering why everyone else shines out. Stuck in a bottle that never got the chance to touch the sea.
Thank you. that thing.
Welcome, everybody. I'm Pastor Drew, and it is my joy and honor to have Lisa as our
pianist at our church every Sunday. She didn't make it this morning. For some reason, she didn't show up. We're gathered here in the sight of God and all of you as witnesses to unite Lisa Sliger and Tony Hood in holy matrimony. So if you're not here for that, you're in the wrong place. Thank you for being here anyway. Well, their first date, not everybody knows, was right over there at the end of that pier. The first time they saw each other face to face, right? And then that was also the very spot where Tony proposed to Lisa. And so it's very appropriate and fitting that we have this service right here in sight of that. Scripture tells us that God created marriage, and therefore it is proper for us to consider this a worship service in the presence of our Almighty God. And so I invite each of us now to take some time and make a little space in your hearts for God at this time. In Genesis 2, it says, "It's not good for a man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him." Well, Lisa and Tony have found in each other much more than a suitable helper. And so they stand before all of us today to begin a new chapter in their lives together. Now, entering into a new chapter requires leaving and moving on from another chapter. So I ask, who gives Lisa's hand in marriage today?
I do.
Her mother died. Wonderful.
Right here.
Yes,
I do the front.
Okay.
Got it?
Yep, got it.
Please be seated. Well, Lisa and Tony, as you prepare to take these vows, I want you to prayerfully consider all the things that you say, for as you declare these things, you are making an exclusive commitment one to the other before God as long as you both shall live. That is a glorious thing. So Lisa and Tony, understanding that God, out of love, has created, ordered, and blessed the covenant of marriage, do you now affirm your desire and your intent to enter into this covenant? Do you? They do. Let's pray. Lord, we come before you on this blessed day, giving you all praise and honor and glory. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us now that we may feel your presence in this place. Gracious God, you are so faithful in your love for us. So look mercifully now upon Lisa and Tony, who have come seeking your blessing. Let your spirit rest upon them, Lord, so that with steadfast love they may honor these promises that they will make this day. We gather and pray in the name of our beloved Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And now, a life together in marriage is not necessarily sustained solely from within itself. God's guiding hand often works through others, people that they surround themselves with, to sustain the marriage. So I ask all of those in Lisa's family, will you do everything in your power to uphold them in this marriage and support them?
Yes.
Your side's got you. All right. Will all of you in Tony's family do everything you can in your power to support them in their marriage? Will you? He was sweating. Well, those were the correct answers, so I will continue. Well, at its core, marriage is not about living together. It's about loving together. It's about loving so much that somebody else's needs come before our own desires. It's about loving no matter what. Now, there's many things that can get way of a marriage. There's many things that can get way of a relationship, and we all know that, yet nothing can get in the way of true love. And our greatest examples of love are contained in the Bible, where it's mentioned over 500 different times. Now, I thought about starting through all of those, but I know you don't want to stand out here too long. So I could read a whole lot of them right now, but instead I'm just going to read one particular one from the book of 1 John chapter 4, which speaks about the very source of love. John says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God, and whoever does not love does not know God. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world that we might live through him. This is love, not that we love God, that he loved us and sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. So John says, dear friends, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. And he says, no one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and his love is made complete in us. Now there's many expressions of love, and today we particularly celebrate its expression right here in Lisa and Tony, who clearly love each other so much. And I want all of us here today to think of God whenever we think of love. There can be no greater expression of love than what we have from God. And God's love overflows into all of creation around us. It flows into all of humanity for all of times, and it flows right into our hearts, and it flows into this marriage that is happening right now. Marriage is bound up in love, and love is bound up in God. And therefore, whether we're here experiencing a wonderful wedding service like this or out in the world, we give all glory and honor and praise to God, who is the source of all love. Amen. So, Lisa and Tony, you've been dying to touch each other, so give your flowers to your lovely daughter over there. Since it's your intent, join your hands and face each other, and with these promises, bind yourselves to each other as husband and wife. So the question, do you, Tony, take Lisa to be your lawfully wedded wife? And do you promise before God and all of these witnesses to be her loving and faithful husband, whether in good times or in bad, when you're happy and when you're mad, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as you both shall live, do you?
Always.
Always. Excellent. Do you, Lisa, take Tony to be your lawfully wedded husband? Do you promise before God and all of these witnesses to be his loving and faithful wife in good times and bad, when happy and when mad, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and health, as long as you both shall live, do you?
Okay.
She will. What sign do you have to show of this covenant? Their kids brought me these rings, so we're going to say a little prayer over them. So let us pray. Great and holy Lord, we pray your blessing upon these rings. We pray your blessing upon this marriage. We pray that these will be a sign to the world of their unending love for each other and your unending love for us. May they be signs and seals of this covenant they make this day, and may they live and wear them joyfully. Amen. So first, Tony, take her ring. Place it on her finger and repeat after me. Lisa, I give you this ring as a sign of my unending love for you. And my commitment, to be your husband.
Be your husband.
Great. Now, Lisa, you can take his ring and place it on his finger and repeat after me. Tony, I give you this ring as a sign of my unending love for you and my commitment to be your wife. Well, these rings shall be a visible sign to the world of these vows that they just took, symbols of Tony and Lisa's unending love for each other. Now, there's many things that are used to symbolize the union of two lives, and they have chosen to demonstrate their new life together with a ceremony of sand. So I'm going to ask you guys to come back over here with me. There's one for you. One for you. And notice their sand is color coordinated to their colors. Lovely. So, these two separate vessels of sand symbolize your separate lives before you found each other. And it's appropriate that you switch sides here. Your life and all the people that you surrounded with you, yourself with, your daughters and so many other people here. And then yours, your sons and all your other family here. They symbolize your separate friends, your separate family, your separate choices. And so once your sands are blended together, They can't be separated. We all know that. Once you put sand together, it cannot be separated. Just as the sand cannot be separated, your lives cannot be separated after today. So by blending the sand today, you're not just recognizing the union of yourselves, but you're also recognizing the importance of blending your two families together, and that's a joyous thing. Well, Jesus said in Mark chapter 10, he said, what God has joined together, let no one separate. And so may it be so with you guys. Lisa and Tony, no matter what happens, I want to make sure that you remember this day and recall these vows that you've made before God and all of these witnesses. Remember the day that you met just over there, and remember the day when you realized almost immediately that your values and your lives had so much in common. And that's a glorious story. Make sure you share that with people. And so remember also the day that you spent right out there saying yes to spending the rest of your lives together. And don't ever forget that the deepest root in your relationship is the love that you have for one another. Don't ever forget that deepest root. That love will be at the heart of your lives together. It'll be at the heart of all the joys that you experience, and it has the ability to carry you through whatever challenges you may face in your marriage. So don't ever let go of that love as a root of this day. Let us pray. Eternal God, we pray that you would strengthen this love between Lisa and Tony with patience, kindness, gentleness, and all the other wonderful gifts of your Spirit, so that they may fulfill these vows that they have made. Fill them, Lord, with such love and joy that they may build a home of peace and welcome that honors your will for the world. Guide them, dear Lord, by your word to serve you faithfully all of their days. Help us all, O God, to do your will in each of our relationships, homes, and lives, and enrich our lives with the awareness of your presence so that we may serve others as ourselves and hasten the coming of your peace, love, and justice on earth. This we pray through Jesus Christ, the Lord of love. Amen. Well, the words have been said. God's word has been proclaimed. Your vows have been made. Your rings have been shared. Your sands have been blended into one. But there is one final thing to declare, right? I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. And now I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Tony Hood. Thank you. Lisa and Tony, thank you all for being part of their lives, and especially for being part of this most special day. And since they're still nearby, let's give them one more round of applause. So they're going to go away and take some photos of the wedding party and all that, and they invite all of you. They have hors d'oeuvres and refreshments available for you up there in the hall. So make your way over there, and as soon as we're all cleared out, they'll be able to get started on their photographs and then join us later. Thank you.